It's Jojo. I'm just here getting ready for bed. I am super tired because I've been only working on 4 hours sleep. And I didn't really sleep throughout all those 4 hours. I wanted to sit and talk to you guys about the very tough week I had. It was a very, very, very dramatic week. And I'm glad I got through it. But it wasn't with my own strength. It was with God's strength, because it was very hard. I can say that the biggest things that got me through it is being very, very grateful for who and what I have. Material things were lost, and that's fine. The biggest thing I would say that I feel was that it hurt me. It hurt what happened. It hurt to feel guilty and not know if you really had anything to do with it, if you were targeted from what happened. And I really can't mention exactly what was it that exactly happened, because it's still under investigation. But I felt bad, and I wasn't feeling much of myself. Like, I wasn't feeling myself at all. I felt lost, confused, and I still, in partly, feel that way. Because it was difficult for me. I guess it was difficult to comprehend why things were done, or what was the reason behind all this. And what mostly got to me was the fact that I wanted to know the answers, and I still do. I want to know why was this done, what happened, and I mean, I'm not sure why people do things the way they do. There are ways to do things, and I don't think the way that things were done was a way. I'm not sure if I insulted anyone or if I offended anyone by anything I did. I am completely confused. I honestly don't feel myself. It's kind of hard to simulate what happened. And I'm very grateful throughout it too, because God bless him, I thank him for that. But at the same time, it's like, it was a very scary situation, and I don't wish it upon anyone, because for a while now I've been feeling confused and I've been feeling lost within myself, if that makes sense. It's not an easy feeling. It's been very hard. There's been tears, there's been anxiety. I actually thank my little supporter. Blue, wake up! Blue! She looks at me like, bro, you know, tired. But anyways, she's my little motion support dog. I'm thankful for her. She's been through my side, so has my husband. He's been with me as well, and I'm thankful for my family and that they're all okay. I want to understand what happened. I want answers. I want to know what exactly was caused this, because it's been uneasy for me. It hasn't been easy going for me, and I'm the type of person that wants to understand the reason behind things. I want to have the answers. I want to know the why to things.
I'm sorry.
I'm only working on 4 hours of sleep, and it's like I'm really, really tired. And I'm sorry if I don't make sense throughout this process. For the little things. Be grateful for the big things. And I don't know what your situation is, but in every situation, like the situation that I've been through, in anybody's situation, sometimes we feel like we fall off this mountain that we have been climbing, and we're halfway there, and all of a sudden we fall. And we're like, what's the point of climbing this mountain again? Well, yeah, it's understanding that it could be frustrating. But if you look at it this way, it's easier for us as humans to get up and try to climb that mountain again. If we first started off at the bottom of the mountain, it's a lot easier because we have the experience. We know what it's like to start from the bottom and climb up. We know what it's like to go through those things, and they're similar, and we gain experience from it. And the more we go through experiences, the more we learn, the better we get at this game. Not that life is a game, but we get better at what we do. It's easier for us to succeed because we have experience, rather than if we were at the top of the mountain and have us fall and not know how to even climb one. My point is, don't stop trying. The more you try, the easier it gets. It may get frustrating because you feel like, well, now we're having to do this over again. Well, now we're having to start over again. I know what it's like. And I know what it feels like. I know what it's like to go through the fire, or even literally, I know what it's like to lose it all. Luckily, not family-wise. But I know what it's like to feel like we have lost it all. That we have nothing else to do. Or like, how, like asking the type of questions like, well, how are we going to see the day of tomorrow? I've asked those type of questions before. I felt like I have dead ends in my path before, and they're not pretty, they're not nice, but they didn't stop me, and they shouldn't stop you. I know what it's like to go through a horrible bad week, and it feels like the worst thing ever, and it feels like you just want to be in bed and not get up. It's just kind of, that's kind of ironic since I am going to bed, but that's because I need to go to bed, not because I'm depressed. But don't give up. Do what you love because you love it. Yes, I'm not telling you not to have ambition. Have that ambition. Don't get comfortable. I'm not telling you to get comfortable, throw your shoes to the side, throw the towel, and give up. I'm not telling you that. I'm telling you to be grateful and learn to be grateful for the things that you have. So when you have more, you know what it's like to have less. And if you were to lose what you have now, you can gain it all back. It's a lot easier. I'm not saying that you will lose it. I'm saying that if you were to lose it, it would be easier. But be grateful for the bad moments and the good moments, because the bad moments are the ones that make you grow. Be careful not to fall in frustration and just give up and walk away. Continue to conquer life. Continue to fight. It could get hard. It could get tiring. But as long as you're living, you're still counting. It's not as easy as it sounds, because I've been in that same position, feeling like I don't know why I'm trying, feeling like what's the point to all this? I always hit dead ends. I mean, it's, what's the point? But it's not that. It's that we need to stand like warriors. We can either sit here and complain or get up and fight. We can either sit here and cry or get up and do something about what we want, about what we need, about our life, about success. And I'm not telling you to do things the wrong way. I'm telling you to do things the right way. Because when you do things the right way, they're a lot more stable than when you do things the wrong way. I probably make no sense because I'm so tired. But if I did, and I hope I did, I hope that I inspired you to keep going, not to give up, to put the chin up, so that you won't drop your crown. Life's a struggle. Life's a battle. At the end of the day, we have to be grateful for the little things and the great things. Learn to not give up. Learn that we get tired, we cry, we throw the towel, but then we pick it back up and keep walking and keep trying and keep climbing the mountain. It's not the end of the day. If we're still living, we're still counting. And remember, be polite because it goes a long way. And stay tuned because soon enough I will be posting a video about tips and tricks of travel. Thank you for watching. Stay blessed. Be thankful. Love you guys and be safe. And to be grateful. I'm here and I realized that on my previous video that you probably already watched, I did not mention how I got through my hard week. Basically what I did, I know that I did some motivational speech at the end of this, or at the end of the other video. I wanted to say the first thing I did was get up because I couldn't sleep. I could not sleep. I was very paranoid and anxious and whatever I felt that day. But I was like, no, I have to get up. I can't sleep either way. I'm going to start to edit my video from Puerto Rico, which is not watched. It's on Far Ever Travels, and it's on but it's under not Far Ever Travels. And yeah, I began to edit that video. I was a little bit frustrated, but it helped me focus on what I needed to focus. And right after that, I caught my husband on the way out, and I was like, no, you wait for me because we're going to the gym. And he expected me not to have or be in a mood to go to the gym, but it was the best workout that I can honestly say is my best workout that I had done in the longest time. And I know that I sweat, and I didn't leave that gym until I was sore because I worked out my frustration and I worked out my stress and my anxiety, and I left it all at the gym. Later that day, things got better, and it was great because I felt like it was all in God's plan, and it worked amazingly. And you know, only He knows how things work out, and He does things certain ways that we won't personally mess with. And that's what I understood that day, that if He would have done things right away, I most likely would have messed it up at some point. But I thank God that He guided me in the right direction, and that things went pretty well. I hit the gym hard, and also thank God because I have a great boss and great leaders at work who understood what I was going through. And I honestly thank them because they have also been a blessing in my life. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope I didn't get you guys depressed, but instead that I motivated you guys to continue with life regardless of what happens or what gets you down. So thanks for watching, Jojo La Manzanita with you, and thanks for having tea with me, even though this time I didn't have tea.